Looking into the deepest, oldest corners of the universe is like stepping into a time machine. And our most powerful time machine right now, the James Webb Space Telescope, has brought us a surprising message from the past. Astronomers have detected more than 300 unexpectedly bright objects shining at the dawn of the universe. These objects could be galaxies straight from the first pages of cosmic history. In fact, one of them has already been confirmed through spectroscopy to be at a redshift of 8.679, placing it just a few hundred million years after the Big Bang. So, what does this mean? These discoveries could fundamentally shake everything we know about galaxy formation. Now, we will delve deep into what these mysterious lights are and how they could reshape our understanding of the universe's earliest moments. First of all, it's essential to understand how this discovery was made. The James Webb Space Telescope is designed to capture faint, ancient light from the most distant corners of the universe. This makes it the perfect tool for investigating the universe's infancy. Researchers targeted four different regions of the sky that are particularly empty. These deep sky fields were deliberately chosen to ensure that bright nearby stars or galaxies wouldn't block the view of much fainter targets behind them. In total, they scanned an area of about 500 arc minutes, roughly half the area covered by the full moon. For this mission, two of Webb's key instruments were used, the near-infrared camera, NIRCam, and the mid-infrared instrument, MIRI. But why infrared? The answer lies in the universe itself. The universe has been expanding for over 13 billion years. This expansion stretches the light from distant galaxies like a rubber band, lengthening its wavelength. This process is called redshift. This effect shifts what would normally be visible light into the infrared spectrum, Webb's area of expertise. The higher the redshift, the more distant, and therefore the older the object we are looking at. Finding the first galaxies in such a massive dataset is no different than looking for a needle in a haystack. This is where scientists use a clever technique, the dropout method. You can think of this technique like this. Imagine you have a set of color filters, blue, green, red, and even redder. A very distant galaxy has been so redshifted by the expansion of the universe that it becomes invisible when viewed through bluer filters. That's because the light at those wavelengths is completely absorbed by the neutral hydrogen gas between us and the galaxy. This sharp cutoff is called the Lyman break. However, when you look at the same galaxy through redder filters, it suddenly begins to shine. This disappearing in blue filters and appearing in red ones is the most distinct fingerprint of a high redshift candidate. After identifying potential candidates with this method, the team moved on to a second step called spectral energy distribution SED fitting. In this method, the brightness of an object across different filters is compared with theoretical galaxy models. This comparison allows for strong estimates of the object's redshift, mass, and age. When the analyses were complete, the picture that emerged was astonishing. Of the 137 objects with both near and mid-infrared data, about two-thirds appeared to be normal, closer galaxies with redshifts between 1 and 4. However, at least 7% of them showed signs of being much more distant, meaning they existed in the first few hundred million years of the universe. And most importantly, these candidates had one standout feature: their unexpected brightness. According to current galaxy formation models, the first galaxies are expected to be generally small, faint, and primitive. These models suggest that galaxies gradually gain mass over time by merging and through sustained star formation. However, the objects Webb found appear much brighter and larger than these models predict for their potential age. It's as if they started the cosmic race earlier and much faster than everyone else. This raises a fundamental question. Are our models wrong, or are these objects not what they seem? We are faced with two main possibilities. Scenario 1. Galaxy formation was much faster and more efficient than we thought. Perhaps these galaxies formed at the centers of massive dark matter halos, that collapsed rapidly in the early universe. These halos would have created deep gravitational wells, pulling in surrounding gas at an incredible rate. This intense gas accumulation could have triggered a burst of star formation much earlier and more violently than models predict. If this is true, we will need to revise our theories about the early universe. However, there is a second scenario. These objects could be cosmic impostors that are fooling us. In other words, they might be galaxies at a lower redshift that just happen to look very distant because of their colors. For instance, objects known as dusty starburst galaxies produce stars at very high rates within dense clouds of gas and dust. The dust they contain absorbs most of their light and re-emits it in the infrared, making them appear extremely red. Another type of impostor is an active galactic nucleus. The intense light emitted from matter being consumed by a central supermassive black hole can overwhelm the galaxy's own light, altering its colors in a misleading way. While the dropout technique is very efficient for finding candidates, it's not definitive. Factors like dust, unusual star populations, or active black holes can easily make a galaxy's color misleading. This is where science's most powerful tool comes into play: spectroscopy. While imaging and color analysis provide a general portrait of an object, spectroscopy reveals its true identity, its very DNA, so to speak. In this technique, the light from a galaxy is split into its component wavelengths, much like light passing through a prism. The emission or absorption lines that appear in this spectrum provide definitive, indisputable information about the object's chemical composition, star formation rate, and most importantly, its redshift. The next step in this research is exactly that. Using spectroscopy instruments like Webb's NIR spec and giant ground-based telescopes, the light from these 300 candidates will be analyzed one by one. These analyses will reveal the source of their brightness. Is it an unusual burst of star formation, an active supermassive black hole, or a combination of both? If a significant portion of these 300 candidates is confirmed to be beyond a redshift of 8, meaning they are indeed from the early universe, it would pose a serious challenge to existing theories of galaxy formation. We would need to update our models to account for galaxies assembling and producing stars much earlier. This could radically change our understanding of gas cooling processes, star formation efficiency in primordial conditions, and the role of dark matter. On the other hand, if most of these objects turn out to be closer, dusty galaxies, or other impostors, that would also be an incredibly valuable result. It would allow us to sharpen our methods for distinguishing real high redshift galaxies from fakes in future surveys. Additionally, we would gain important insights into these dusty and active galaxies in more recent cosmic epochs. What James Webb has presented us with these 300 bright objects is not just a discovery, but a cosmic riddle. One has been confirmed, but what about the others? When the answers arrive, we will either rewrite the first chapter of the universe or improve our methods for reading its book. In either case, our knowledge of the cosmos will be irreversibly enriched.